define who you are, I think it's totally different regardless of what people may say about you or think about you. Where people are defining themselves. And it's a visual interpretation of people being able to say, I'm creative, I'm a giver, I'm a procrastinator, I'm insecure, whatever those words are, but being able to say those words for yourself, define yourself, and not allow other people to define you. And so just something I wanted to do, you know. Who I am at 42 is totally different than who I was at 20. And who I am at 42 prayerfully will be different than who I am at 60. You know, so the projects really just get around people being courageous enough to define who they are without allowing outside forces to specifically say who they are. When we first started the project, the way we kind of got participants was social media. We use Instagram, we use Facebook, and basically we just asked people to come up with 5 to 10 words to define who they are. And so we went through all of the different meanings that people had sent us and all the people who participated. It was about maybe 200, 250 people, and just kind of broke it down and grabbed about 60 people to kind of work with, because we want to have 42 people that we ultimately have these pictures of, with them and their words being written on their bodies. And so we started the project, did the first shoot on about 3-4 days ago, and it was really remarkable, you know, and really just being able to look at the photos and look at how words that people have used to define them, putting that on their body, really made a statement and kind of let people know, this is who I am. You know, you may say one thing, but this is who I am. And so far the feedback has been great, you know, and we've been having folks to come out and participate and really leave out feeling different and feeling empowered and feeling uplifted and feeling like, yeah, this is who I am and this is how I define me, you know. And that's the whole project, the 42nd project, defined by me. And so that's what we've been seeing, and it's really been a great process. I just really want people to feel like they define who they are. You know, I think sometimes, you know, you can ask somebody who you are, and it can be a challenging moment, because a lot of times we don't necessarily think about defining us. So I may say I know who I am, but I can't really define who I am. And I think that when you define who you are, the good and the bad, because I think this whole project isn't just geared around saying the definitions that are all positive, you know, but realizing that there's stuff in us that's not positive. And I think that when you are able to really put a definition to those things, then it allows you to be able to change those things. How can you change what you can't define? You know, and so if I say I'm a procrastinator, then it gives me an opportunity to realize that I can change that. I don't always have to be a procrastinator, you know. And so the project isn't just so much geared around just people defining themselves, but it's also hopefully will challenge us to change those things about us that we don't necessarily like. Hopefully this project uplifts, but it also challenges. Hopefully it encourages us, but it also makes us reflect and look at us and recognize that everything about us isn't necessarily who we have to be, and that we can make the steps to be different. And so I hope that's what people kind of grab from this. You know, no longer letting people define you, being able to define yourself, but at the same time, no longer allowing people to change you, but realizing and recognizing that once you've defined yourself, you can change yourself.